Okay. So I haven't had a new computer in probably like 15 years. I've always used an old computer. I never seen a reason to have a new one. So I was looking at the all the pre-builts that are out there, and I looked at CyberPower, iBuyPower, and Dell, pretty much, were the only ones that I had competitive pricing on. And I like this one because it's very configurable. It uses standard parts, and it's an iBuyPower GXI 3400 BS TV8. Now, I'm not saying the other ones are any worse or any better. It's just that this one I thought I could update enough to make it usable. As far as I can tell from the reviews, the only thing that's really bad about this machine is the CPU overheats. And I agree with that. I didn't expect anything from this keyboard and mouse. I thought they were just going to be junk, and they're actually really good keyboard and mouse. So if you think you're going to get a junky keyboard and mouse, it's not going to happen with this. It's not mechanical, but it's nice. And here's the sticker that's on the box. Let me do a zoom on it. There's the zoom on the label. And I'm going to do a lot of videos on this. Basically, the first video is just going to show you what I got. And then after that, we'll do a video on how to set it up, because it's not simple for most people to set this up at first. They don't make it very easy, but you can do it with a little guidance. And then I'm going to show you what the problem is with this system, because there is a problem with it, and I'm going to show you how to resolve it. I'm going to show you how to update it and upgrade it. I'm probably going to put like 8 drives in this thing. Maybe 7, I don't know, but they're going to be really big drives in the end. Probably 4 terabyte, 8 terabyte drives. And I might put some extra fans in there. I don't think it's necessary, but it's possible to put 3 more fans on top. And I'll show you that in the next part. Got 16 gigs of RAM and dual channel, 3200 speed. It's got a heatsink on the voltage regulators. At least I think that's what's under there. It's got a 500 gig Western Digital M2. It's got a 600 watt power supply, name brand. And it's got this Asus GeForce RTX. It's an Asus. The motherboard is a Gigabyte. And I'll let you know the model number. And that's about it. But it's got plenty of room in here. It's got multiple fans. And I'll show you the other side. Here's the motherboard sheet they give you. There's the motherboard's model number. It's a Gigabyte. And here's what it looks like. And I'll show you the other page. Here's some more information. I'm glad that it's a Gigabyte or a name brand, because you can get anything in these things. And I'm going to do a really good video as far as upgrading this. I expect to put like 8 drives in this thing. And it's going to have multiple uses. It's going to be a video editor, a gaming system, and probably a Plex server as well. I could never build certain things because I had like a lower end machine. So you're going to see a lot of information from here. Might take a couple of videos actually. Before I forget, I wanted to show you the only component in the system that's not good. And it's that CPU fan. It's a Cooler Master, and it's like a low-end fan. And as far as what I can tell from the reviews, people are getting 90, 100 degrees running off this cheap fan, and it needs to be replaced. I'm going to show you that, how to do that, actually. Okay, so this is the side of the case, the back side of the case. And you got all these ports, and there's your video ports. You don't use any of the video ports on the actual motherboard. You use the video ports from here. So this is the back side of the motherboard. You can see that they put the bracket in here for the CPU cooler. There's the power supply, 600 watts, EV3A. It's got a terabyte drive, and it's got a M2 inside as well. Now, on the bottom here is where all the action's going to occur. There's additional power down here. Basically, it's on this chain of Molexes down here, and that's where you're going to be doing a lot of power connections. At least I am, anyway, because I'm going to be putting most likely two more SD drives in here. I'm going to keep this mechanical 1 terabyte because it came for free. And then you could put two more SD cards here, drives here. So I'm going to have two drives here, two over here, one mechanical 3.2 drive or 3.5, and the M2. And actually, there's another spot for an M2 inside. So you could basically have 2, 4, 6, 8 drives in this machine. Thinking about 8 terabyte drives in SD format, and they're pretty expensive, so I might do that over time. And then you got your two back fans here. Many videos say to flip these fans around so that they suck air in, because right now they're blowing air out. And we might do a test on that. And then you got your connections up here. I wanted to show you really quickly, like on the side of the case where those two fans are in the back, there's actually vents for the fans. And you'd think this would be a simple thought, but a lot of the pre-made machines don't even bother putting vents into the machine when they put fans in. And they did the right thing. They put the fans in the right place. In fact, on the top here, I'll show you with it open, that you could put three more fans in there. It's already got three fans and the CPU fan inside. But look, you could put three more in there. Really simple access. You would connect to that connector that I showed you earlier. And I'm going to be doing a lot of that, so...